Welcome back to National Defense Channel. U.S. Marine Corps to transform JLTVs in anti-aircraft role. The purpose is to detect, track, identify, and defeat aerial threats from drones and fixed-wing and rotary-wing aircraft. The U.S. Marine Corps wants to see whether its joint light tactical vehicles can be used to defend against threats in the air. Let's take a look. Fighting air threats. Enemy attacks don't always come via land. In fact, as history has been telling us, enemies can also use weapons in the air. Airborne weapons, including fighters, helicopters, and drones, are particularly threatening because they could easily reach their targets. To mitigate and combat these threats, the U.S. military has been developing mobile air defense systems. Of course, there is no harm in getting resourceful even in times of peace. Even land-based vehicles can be useful against airborne threats. For this reason, the U.S. Marine Corps wants to see to whether its JLTVs can become mobile air defense systems that could track and eliminate enemy fighters, helicopters, and drones. JLTVs as air defense systems. According to a report, the program manager Ground-Based Air Defense is developing the so-called Direct Fire Defeat System. The Marine Corps Systems Command has already invited defense companies to pitch their ideas to create the system. Under the program, Marine Air Ground Task Force commanders will be provided with JLTVs that are equipped with anti-aircraft missiles, 30mm cannons, and electronic warfare technology. The purpose is to detect, track, identify, and defeat aerial threats from drones, unmanned aerial systems, and fixed-wing and rotary-wing aircraft, fighters, and helicopters. Costly but necessary. The Marine Corps program is just part of the current initiative by the U.S. military to boost its air defense capabilities. In fact, the U.S. Army is already working on its maneuver short-range air defense system, which entails arming Striker combat vehicles with Hellfire missiles, a 30mm chain gun, a 7.62 machine gun, as well as 4 Stinger missiles. These defense programs will cost millions or even billions of dollars of taxpayers, but hey, it's better to be prepared than sorry.